Okay, so this is a continuation of my Toys That Teach series, and this comes from Safariology, Safari Limited, and this is the life cycle of a chicken. Now, I'm pretty impressed right off the bat with Safariology. I purchased all of these off of Amazon at full price. These are for children, 4 and older. And included in the pack, number one here, you have the egg, so it's a nest with eggs in it, and the hatchling, which is already cracked out of its egg. You get a chick that has dried out since hatching out of its egg. And then, of course, you get the adult hen. So these are all pretty nice. They're small, but the details are pretty good. And we're going to go over the whole thing. We're going to take them out, and I'm going to review these. If your child likes to read, on the back of the package, there are details about the items that are in the pack, and also where it comes from. Safari Limited, Miami Lakes, Florida. These are hand-painted, so that's kind of a nice feature. These are not really plastic toys. This looks more like a heavy ceramic. And it is matte finish, so kind of a cross to me between ceramic and heavy plaster work. I wouldn't be throwing these around. You wouldn't want your child to toss these in a toy box or something like that. I think they will chip up. And we're looking close to the legs here. Look how thick the legs are on this hen. So I'm thinking we're dealing with a Cornish hen here, a meat bird. And this is a great way to introduce children to the chicken. Now, absent from the collection, of course, is a rooster. I don't know why they do that. We're just going to look at the bottom here. These things all stand on their own well, and this will be suitable for a collection that your child can display in their room, on the shelf. We have the comb here on the top, the wattles underneath, and a nice sharp beak there. The details are great. Now, normally, there would be ears too. The saddle feathers, tail feathers, and of course the flight feathers here. They don't seem to show the primary and secondary flights, but I'm not uptight about this at all. There's nice down across the back. And again, looking at it from the top, whoever carved these originally did a very nice job. The feet are great. The shape of the hen is great. And I'm just impressed. So if you're going to use something to teach your kids, normally again, there would be earlobes here. If they're white, you're going to get a white-shelled egg. If they were red, you'd get a brown-shelled egg. And if it's Americana, for example, the Easter eggs would come from it. So then we have a nest, and it looks like they put it in straw. And we have 3 eggs. Now, what's cool about this is the texture of the material that these are made from really does look like egg texture. So if you're trying to teach a child that eggs are semi-porous and that the developing chick will breathe through the shell, it's believable here. The texture is nice. And a hen would sit these eggs for 21 days, and then they would hatch out. So you might end up having to give that lecture about where these eggs came from and why it's fertile, and which leaves me wondering why they did not include the rooster. Now here's the chick after it's cracked out of its egg, pipped and hatched, and the cracks in the eggshell are really convincing. Again, nice texture. It appears porous. It looks like a real egg to some degree. And the chick even looks like its down feathers are wet. There's even a little bump out here on the top of its beak that looks like it might have had an egg tooth on it. If they just touched that with a little bit of white paint, it would be even more convincing. But again, great tool to teach children about the hatching egg. And the chick would come out and would have to dry off in the brooder or underneath its mother. And this is great. The details are awesome. It's peeking over the edge of the shell. Its little feet are off to the side because they have to get their footing. They have to come out. Hopefully you're not going to put them on slick newspaper, but instead you're going to put them on something they can get traction and stand up on. And a chick is ready to go. They absorb albumin, and they have everything they need for several days. And here's the nice fluffy chick the way it would have been after it's dried out and running around. Food and water. Chicks are set for 2 to 3 days. Again, as I said, they absorb the white of the egg before they hatch out. And this allows the mother to sit on the nest long enough for the rest of the clutch to hatch out. And then they'll run around and she'll show them where to find food. So again, these are great collectible quality. I'm going to say I really like these. I mean, all the features are here. They did a great job of showing a plump, round little chick here. And again, this looks like it would be a Cornish chick. Nice heavy feet. Let's get all the pieces together the way you might display them on a shelf. If a child is going to start a collection of animals and insects and things like that, I'm going to have to say that Safariology is high on my list right off the bat here. I definitely like the way they look. They're small, but again, be cautioned. I don't think these toys are going to handle being thrown in your toy box. I don't think, if you've got a child that's rough with their toys, you're going to have to set these apart or let them play with them under supervision. I think the details are great. I mean, you're seeing it. It looks like the legs on the chick, since it's hand-painted, it looks like they might have missed a couple spots there. But if we're going to explain the life cycle of a chicken, I think that this is pretty good. The hen, the egg. You know, a chicken lays an egg every 25 hours, roughly, and they only lay during daylight. Their pituitary gland is stimulated by light. And she'll lay a clutch of eggs, and she's going to sit on those and hatch them on the 21st day. They'll pip about the 18th, 19th day and stop moving around, so she'll stop turning the eggs. And you'll have yourself some Cornish chicks. Great introduction. Here's the collection. Thank you for watching, and I definitely give this 5 stars. This is a great collection, and you're going to see more in the series from Safariology. Thanks for watching.